Hello everyone, today we are going to see the first chapter in civics, which is modern democracy. In the previous class, we have already seen about historic perspective, modern democracy, elected representative, rule of law, social democracy and economic democracy. Synopsis of the lesson. In this session, we are going to see the following topics. The first one is making democracy successful. Then we have fundamental rights. Under this, we have right to equality, right to freedom, right against exploitation, right to freedom of religion, cultural and educational rights, right to constitutional remedies, political equality, social equality and economic equality. First, we have to know what is mean by democracy. The word democracy literally means rule by the people. Supreme power is given to the people and exercised by them directly or indirectly through a system of representation. So, democracy is a form of government in which the rulers are elected by the people. According to Abraham Lincoln, democracy is a government of the people, by the people and for the people. Now, we are going to learn about making democracy successful. You have studied about the various aspects of democracy, right? But there are some essential means necessary conditions which make the democracy successful. These are as follows. The first point is that democracy will be strong if people are educated and aware of their rights and duties towards their country. The second point is that they should be disciplined and obey the law. So what is mean by law? Law means set of rules. Then the people should take interest in the formation of the government. They should exercise. Here, exercise means use or apply their right to vote. The people should keep themselves informed about the policies of the government. So what is mean by policy? Policy refers to a rule or plan of action, especially an official one adopted and followed by a government. They should formulate. Here formulate means convey or communicate public opinion. If they feel that the policies are not fair or not in general interest of the public. Next, they should be aware of the right to question the government but not take law into their own hands. The democratic power of pulling down a government is strong enough to remove a government which is not performing as per their wishes. While we studied about democracy in general, in the section above, let us see some highlights of how democracy is special in India. Now, let's see some keywords. Fundamental rights. So what is mean by fundamental? Fundamental means basic or primary. Rights literally mean those freedoms which are essential for personal good as well as the good of the community. So fundamental rights are rights important for the happy and healthy living of the people of the country and are generally spelt out in the constitution of the country. Now, let's see the meaning of fundamental rights. Fundamental rights are essential human rights that are offered to every person, irrespective of caste, race, creed, place of birth, religion or gender. These are equal to freedom, and these rights are essential for personal good and the society at large. First, we have to know what is mean by constitution. A constitution is a basic design which deals with the structure and powers of the government. It also includes rights and duties of citizens. It provides the framework for the organization of the state government. Next, we are going to learn about fundamental rights. Before that, let's see some keywords: freedom, equality, justice. So what is mean by freedom? Freedom means the power or right to act, speak or think as one wants without hindrance. Here hindrance means obstacle or restriction. Equality means the state of being equal, especially in status, rights or opportunities. Justice means fairness or honesty. In India, our constitution provides us some fundamental rights. These rights allow people to grow and prosper in an environment of freedom. So what is mean by freedom? The power or right to act, speak or think as one wants without hindrance, which means obstacle or restriction. Equality means the state of being equal, especially in status, rights or opportunities, and justice, which means fairness or honesty. Now, let's see the six fundamental rights in India: right to equality, right to freedom, right against exploitation, right to freedom of religion, cultural and educational rights, right to constitutional remedies. First, we are going to learn about right to equality. The Indian Constitution provides its citizens the following fundamental rights. The first one is right to equality. Equality before law implies all persons are considered equal in the eyes of the law. So, right to equality means that all the citizens are equal to in the eyes of the law. The next point is that no discrimination on the basis of religion, race, caste or gender. So what is mean by discrimination? Discrimination is when a person is treated unfairly or badly because the person is one of a particular group. So no discrimination on the basis of religion, race, caste or gender. Untouchability is abolished and is considered as a crime. So what is mean by untouchability? Untouchability is the practice of discriminating various individuals and groups based on their caste and the jobs done by them. Abolished means formally put an end to a system, practice or institution. So untouchability is abolished, which means put an end to a practice and is considered as a crime. The next point is that all citizens have access to all public places like roads, parks, theatres, amusement parks, hospitals, schools, pilgrim centers, railway stations, rail and bus services, etc. All citizens have equal access to employment. Next, we are going to learn about right to freedom. So there are six freedoms. first one is freedom of speech and expression. The second one is freedom of assembly. Third one is freedom of association. Fourth one is freedom of movement. Fifth one is freedom of residence. And sixth one is freedom of profession and trade. Right to freedom. The first point is freedom of speech and expression, which enable an individual to participate in public activities. The second point is that freedom to assemble peacefully and without arms. Here arms means weapons. So freedom to assemble peacefully and without weapons. Freedom to form association and union. Freedom to move freely throughout the territory of India. Freedom to reside, which means live in any part of the country. Freedom to practice any profession or occupation, trade or business. Next, we are going to learn about right against exploitation. Third one is right against exploitation. What is mean by exploitation? Exploitation means the action or fact of treating someone unfairly in order to benefit from their work. The first point is that prohibition of all forms of forced labor, commonly known as bigger, which means forced labor. So what is mean by prohibition? Prohibition means banning, in other words, an order to restrain or stop. So what is mean by prohibition? An order to restrain or stop. All forms of forced labor, commonly known as bigger, which means forced labor. Second point is that prohibition of child labor, children under 14 years of age, which means abolition of employment of children below the age of 14 years in dangerous jobs like factories and mines. It deals with prohibition of employment of children in factories. The third point is that prevents traffic in human beings. Here, traffic refers to human trafficking. So what is mean by human trafficking? Human trafficking is the trade of humans for the purpose of forced labor. So prevents traffic in human beings. Next, we are going to learn about right to freedom of religion. Right to freedom of religion. So what is mean by religion? Religion means the belief in and worship of a superhuman controlling power, especially a personal god or gods. People of the country have a right to follow, practice and preach religion of their choice, which means every citizen of India has a right to promote, practice their religion peacefully. Next, we are going to learn about cultural and educational rights. Cultural and educational rights. All citizens have a right to conserve and develop their own culture. So what is mean by conserve? Conserve means protect. What is mean by culture? Culture means the ideas, customs and social behavior of a particular people or society. So all citizens have a right to protect and develop their own culture. Any community which has a language and a script of its own has the right to protect and develop them. No citizen can be discriminated against for admission in state or state-aided institutions. Next, we are going to learn about right to constitutional remedies. right to constitutional remedies. It is by this right that people of the country have the right to approach the courts if they feel that any of their fundamental right has been violated by the state. In addition to the fundamental rights, there are some fundamental duties as well, which are enshrined in the constitution. What is mean by enshrine? Which means to contain or keep in a place that is highly admired and respected. You shall study about the rights and duties in greater detail in the next class. A very important element of democracy in India is the aspect of equality. Indian constitution caters, which means provides, to give equal status to all its nationals. Equality amongst the citizens is provided in different ways. Let us see them in some detail here. The first one is political equality. What is mean by political? Political means relating to the government or public affairs. Affairs means events of a country. All people who have attained the age of 18 are allowed to take part in the process of formation of the government. This is also known as the universal adult franchise. It means that all adults of any caste, religion, gender, or financial status are allowed to vote for electing the leader of his choosing. Let's see some keywords. Caste, religion. So what is mean by caste? Caste is a division or class of society based on wealth, rank, or occupation. Religion means the belief in and worship of a superhuman controlling power, especially a personal god or gods. Similarly, the people of different castes and religions have equal right to contest the elections and take part in the political process of the country. Next, we have social equality. What is mean by social? Social means relating to society or its organization. In other words, community, group, or public. Every person of India is given equal status in the society. They shall not be discriminated. Here, discriminated means differentiated against on the basis of their caste or religion. People have equal right to visit and enjoy the facilities provided at public places. Finally, we are going to learn about economic equality. So what is mean by economic? Economic means financial. People of India can perceive. What is mean by perceive? Follow or chase someone or something. Any occupation or profession of their choosing. The constitution allows every person equality in terms of employment opportunities. The government, however, has the right to give some preferential opportunities of certain classes which in the past did not get equal opportunities of acquiring education and growth. I have enclosed the classbook instructions in the PDF. Kindly refer it. So now, we have reached the end of this session. Thank you.